Do you receive products or services from overseas vendors whom you continuously owe a balance to? Well, then you should learn about how to use the multi-currency feature when dealing with accounts payable. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The accounts payable feature in QuickBooks is only necessary when you owe money directly to the vendors who perform services for you. Usually, you need to continuously owe them for more than 1 month's worth of service or bills in order to benefit from using the Enter Bills, Pay Bills window in the Accounts Payable feature in QuickBooks. So why is this an accounts payable issue? Well, that's because on the day you receive the service from the vendor, the dollar amount of the currency you owe is based on the exchange rate on the day of service or product delivery, and that should be the date of the bill. So let's imagine that you got a bill for 10,000 Guyana dollars, and on that day, that bill and those 10,000 were worth 80 US dollars. Now let's imagine on the day you go to pay the vendor's bill, the value of that same currency is different because exchange rates change every day. Well, in a case like that, you would have a gain or loss on the exchange at the moment you use the Pay Bills window to pay the bill to the international vendor. For example, let's imagine on April 2nd, you received delivery service from Gina Casina and a bill for the service in the amount of 10,000 Guyanese dollars, and it was bill number 8472. The Guyana dollar was worth only 0.008 US dollars at the moment we received the service and the bill. So what will be the result? Well, we know that accounts payable Guyana dollars will show up for the first time as 80 US dollars, because that's 0.008 of 10,000. So the equivalent of US dollars that you owe will be $80 for the service you received. And because you owed $80, that means you received a service worth $80. And because it was delivery service that you received, delivery expense will increase by 80 US dollars and become $738.40. Let's record the bill. We click Vendor, Enter Bill, and the date of the bill was April 2nd. The vendor was Gina Casina. QuickBooks remembers she gives us delivery service. And again, the date of the bill, well, the due date we'll leave alone, but the amount of the bill is 10,000 Guyana dollars. And at the moment we received the bill, the 10,000 Guyana dollars were in fact worth 0.008 US dollars, making it worth $80. You see right up here. We click Save and Close, and the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Accounts payable in Guyana dollars becomes 80, which is what we owe, and delivery expense in terms of US dollars became $738.40. So now we continue our example, and let's imagine on April 8th, we transferred in enough money from the Chase bank account to the Guyana bank account to be able to pay the whole bill from Gina Casina. On April 8th, the Guyana dollar was worth only 0.007 of the US dollar. So, to make sure that we transfer 10,000 Guyana dollars, we deposited and transferred 70 US dollars into our Guyana bank account, and that became 10,000 Guyana dollars that we will then pay from. So what will be the result just after transferring the money? Well, the Bank of Guyana increases to 70 US dollars because that's what the 10,000 Guyana dollars were worth at the moment we transferred it. And if 70 US dollars transferred to the Guyana bank, that means the Chase bank account here in America decreased by $70 and becomes $2,493 at the moment we transfer the 10,000 units of currency at 0.007. So these will be the results after the transfer on April 8th. We click Banking, Transfer Funds. We put the date April 8, and we're transferring from the American bank account with Chase to the Bank of Guyana. And the number of Guyanese dollars that we're transferring at the moment that we transfer is 10,000, and the exchange rate at this moment is only 7.007. It happens to be there. If not, then you would put it there. Now, when we click Save and Close, the results are exactly as what we expected. The Bank of Guyana now shows 70 US dollars for the 10,000 that we put, and the Chase bank account was decreased by 70 US dollars, and it's the exact number that we predicted or expected. Now let's continue the example, and on the same day, April 8, we actually pay Gina the 10,000 Guyanese dollars that we owe her. So at the moment we pay, on the same day of the transfer, what is the gain? Well, we originally owed 80 US dollars because that was what it was worth when we got the bill. But at the moment we pay, we only owe 70 US dollars because the 10,000 Guyana dollars that we owe are now only worth 70 US dollars. So the decrease per Guyana dollar is 0.001, and that means that when we go to pay this bill, we will have a gain of 10 US dollars because we actually owe $10 less from the moment we owed the money till the moment we paid as a result of the exchange gain. So what will be the result after we pay? Well, both the Bank of Guyana and Accounts Payable Guyana should both become zero. Bank of Guyana becomes zero because we gave all 10,000 units to Gina. And Accounts Payable Guyana should become zero because we gave all 10,000 units to Gina. But we had a $10 gain, which will increase our net gain or loss on exchange, and it will become $31.50. Let's go ahead and pay the bill. We click Vendors, Pay Bills, and of course, we're not paying from regular accounts payable. We're paying from account payable Guyana dollar. And now we see the only Guyana dollar bill we have is this one, so we click the check mark because we're paying the whole bill. QuickBooks remembers the payment date and the exchange rate that we put in a moment ago, but be careful. The money is not coming from the Chase bank account. The money is coming from the Bank of Guyana. And that means the balance will go down to 0 units of currency as we pay 70 US dollars. When we click Pay Selected Bill and then click Done, the Bank of Guyana is zero because we paid all 10,000 Guyana dollars. Accounts payable Guyana is zero because we owe no Guyana dollars at all. And just like what we expected, exchange gain or loss increased to the $31.50 that we expected.